Alexander, would you like to take a seat on the dreamer's chair?
And I shouldn't be doing this. Am I in there?
You're here. Okay, so look to the left.
To the right, my right.
Yeah. And now tell me if you see threads in music.
Do I see threads in music? I think music is full of threads. Synchronicity and all the other things. There's everything in it. Being that it comes from the muse, the Moors, Moorish music, for example, which I would say I'm most interested in, I think it has to have threads.
You think the musician spins a thread?
Yeah, he weaves.
He weaves a thread, and for me, he must, she must, share that thread. And the more people that hold that thread, at the right, with the right amount of strength and gentleness, you can make a tight weave, but you can also make a new type of cloth. And what's interesting is if we have the right mix of givers and receivers, we will have more tapestries. And in the end, are we not just, like I said to you earlier, I was thinking about the magic carpet ride.
Right.
So are musicians and artists making these magic carpets that we can, that give us a floor and safety and comfort to fly high and away from the funnel that we've been put in? We've been funneled into certain ways of being, and you get the funnel coming out in different countries, funneling in different ways.
Right.
And musicians is the kind of ultimate democracy. That
it's beyond democracy.
It's beyond democracy.
Yeah.
It's beyond democracy.
Democracy is is mob rule. It's 50% against. It's 51% against 49%. 51% that win make the rules. The 49 have to suffer them.
Have to suffer. And the people that got there in the first place have you've already discarded so many potential people that would actually help more of us.
Right.
But they don't really want those people because they want just certain people to keep what they have. And the ones that really might have been there in the first place to help so quickly get corrupted.
Yeah.
So quickly.
Yeah.
By getting a few favours.
Yeah.
By being invited to the daughter's wedding.
The wrong dinners.
Certain dinners. I can't be mean to them because they gave me that present.
Yeah.
And suddenly, bit by bit, they've been bought.
They're brought in.
Yeah.
They're brought in. But it's funny you say that about the cloth, because the cloth, I was interviewing Carla Bley and her husband, guitarist. Sorry, I really forgot his name.
I think Miles has been, was brilliant at choosing the people he worked with, and I think in particular he needed players who were compositional. Wayne most certainly, but Bill Evans as well, and numbers of others. Yeah. And as the sort of multitude of Miles' recordings, bootlegs, and all of the rest come out, if you kind of line them up chronologically, you see the extent to which he was in fact composing when he played.
Yeah.
You can see him develop a solo over a period of months and years in a way that Louis Armstrong did as well. You know, And it kind of flies in the face of the that myth that jazz is at its best entirely spontaneous, that you make it up from whole cloth every time you pick up your horn.
And also, when you speak about the carpet, you're speaking about, you know, the magic carpet taking you higher. These are all very connected to all the other magic things that have to do with music. Aladdin, Al means light. All these are clues to what music is really about. You know, what you see generally is the stripping down of all those things. In actual fact, you're really supposed to teach people those things so that they can get a better understanding of not just the music, but their own environment. That's what music is really there for. It's to make, like you say, it's there to make us express our higher self rather than the lower self. That's why they say the beast the beast is quietened by music. I've forgotten the saying, but you know, music tames the beast, the wild beast. That's the lower self. They're really talking about the lower self of a person, which we all have. So, you know, you have people who express themselves in very primitive ways, and if you show them new expression, new art forms, they go to a higher level. They can then come out of that behavior and go to what we call civilization, basically.